a deceiver, supplanter. We all know Jacob as very deceitful. You are the miracle worker. No one reads stories about Jacob without going back and ponder over it. You are not here with me, church. The character was not shown until the destiny of this guy was being unfolded by the mother. Supplanter. A guy who can pretend to be Esau. How do you pretend to be somebody that Isaac can't identify? Such a person is very skillful in deceiving people. Most of us think that it is a story that occurred. It is not a story. It is real. He pretended, covered his hand, showed it to the father, not even thinking that the father could even detect it, but he was still doing it. The reason is, it was his time for God's prophetic mandate to come through. It doesn't matter how the fulfillment of your prophecy will come through. It is God's own ways to bring it to pass. It may sound to be very radical, but if it is of the Lord, it will stand. I wonder, the father can see vision. Indeed, the father can even tell the children that I am about to visit my ancestors. Please, Esau, come here. Go get me venison, such as I love. In other words, the guy is a prophet. He can predict. He can foresee what is ahead of him. But he couldn't see Jacob as a supplanter, a deceiver, because it was predestined and preordained by God. It was ordained. Listen, when the presence of God is about to hit you, it doesn't matter whatever comes your way, it comes to pass whether the devil likes it or not. Jacob, running away from his brothers, came to a place called Luz. He slept and heaven opened over him. A man who deceives someone. How come that heaven will open for someone who have stolen somebody's blessing? And you are not here with me. We call that one the impersonation. Kaluna Masataya. If it is about you, you won't talk to the person who have taken your birthright. But God still reveal himself to Jacob. And ask myself, if Jacob can communicate with God, then as we Christians in this dispensation, we are also qualified to communicate with our God. You are not here with me, church. not selected some few people that he has anointed them to hear from him. Everyone have call of God in their lives. And if you determine to pursue your call, you will definitely. God has not exempted some people and pour oil on them. We were all having the call before our mother even met our father at that restaurant. It was orchestrated by God for your mother to meet your father at Miami Beach. Thank you, Papa. You think it was wrong for your mother to meet your father at Sunny Beach? It is God's orchestration. Things are not just happening anyhow. That is why I always say that in all things, with thanks and supplication, you make a request, but all things work together for our good. He slept and God came to Jacob. He did not reveal himself to Esau. Because when they were caught in their mother's womb, the woman to identify who will become the great. Because the Lord spoke to the woman. It was the woman who gave even the idea for Jacob to follow. In other words, the supplanter idea was being embedded in Jacob because of the mother reaction. So the guy was not bad with it. It was a training the mother put him through that qualifies him how to be supplanter and deceitful. Be careful who is training you. Be careful who is speaking to you if it is not of God. Kadashataya. If it is of God, then that is it. But if it's not God, be careful who's whispered to your ears. Because the voice of many, as we connote it as, is the voice of God. I don't believe it. But the Bible says, I, the Lord, I speak as the sounds of many waters. But he'd not even classify as many voices speaks. Then it's indication that God is speaking. Regardless of what he was running away from, yet he slept. The guy was frustrated because the brother was looking for him. I don't want us to go into the history of it and try to read all the story. We all know the story. While the father blessed Jacob and he ran away, because when Esau get him, he will be in trouble. At times, people ought to lose their place for you to get there. I think you don't like what I'm talking about. I don't feel pity for Esau, because some of the leaders in this country and some of the companies in this particular series and stage, let me say this, some of them are greedy. And they have to lose their seat for those who are in Christ to sit there. So I don't blame Jacob of taking the blessing that belongs to Esau, because it was orchestrated by God. Before they were in their mother's womb, they were even fighting in their mother's womb. These two guys were fighting. When they were coming out, Jacob's hand was holding Esau's leg, that I will not let you come out first. Determination is the key. Christian these days don't determine. We are not focusing. We are not persistent. Persistence breaks resistance. This Jacob may sound to be deceitful, but the guy have a determination spirit. And he's a very fast learner person. The mother taught him and he got it. Can you sleep even when life and people are against you? Can you sleep when life and people are chasing you? That's why I said the peace that we talk about is not about having 1 million in your account. The peace that surpasses all understanding is given to you by God. I feel the anointing here. This guy was sleeping. He was even sleeping. And I knew that when he saw the angels descending and ascending, he was rejoicing. It says, even on the top of the stones is where God came and stood and communicated with Jacob. In the morning, the guy stood up, picked oil, and anointed the stone, and the learning called it Bethel. From stone to the house of God. There are burdens you carry like stones. But because you have Christ in you, you still forego and have a good sleep. At times it's not easy to see yourself going through some tough time. Whilst enemies are chasing you, whilst people are talking against you, why you are perplexed, oppressed, suppressed. All these character assassinators are looking for you to assassinate you. Some of the people are looking for you to just erase you out of this earth realm. But if you know that God has called you, oh God, if you know that you are under the red dial of God, you don't fear what comes your way. Makes all pains beautiful in his time. Your time is coming. Why does God give you such a dream upon all what you have been going through? Just imagine somebody is following you and you go and sleep. You don't think whether the person is coming after you. And why God would give Jacob a dream. Watch this.